Welcome, guys. I am Laura, and you are watching EV News on Jexton Electric. In this edition, we're going to be focusing on Tesla news and updates. Click subscribe and the bell icon so you don't miss out on our next edition. Let's start with Tesla Model Y latest features. Then I will take you on a detailed look at Tesla hardware for computer. Then latest on Tesla's futuristic vehicle, the Cybertruck. Number 1. Auto heating steering wheel. If your vehicle has a heated steering wheel, you will soon be able to set it to auto and have the vehicle control the desired heat from the steering wheel the same way the vehicle controls heated seats. By measuring the current cabin temperature of the vehicle and the temperature at which your air conditioning system is set to. Here is the release note. Automatically heat the steering wheel based on the climate control set temperature. To access the heating controls, tap the temperature settings. Sentry Mode Lightning. Tesla is constantly improving Sentry Mode and adding new features. They added the ability to view the cabin camera directly from the app when Sentry Mode or Dog Mode is active. In this new update, the system will no longer blind passersby with bright headlights when Sentry Mode is enabled. Instead of a full panic mode, it emits gradual headlight pulses, pulsing up and down as a warning. Hopefully, this calm and quiet way of dealing with the problem will result in fewer surprised people being forced into the spotlight. It will also help when viewing clips in Sentry Mode as the environment isn't blown away by light flashes. Here is the release note. When a threat is detected, Sentry Mode will softly pulse the headlights to indicate that your vehicle is recording video. The pulsing stops after 60 seconds or when the vehicle is unlocked. Sentry Mode Life Camera Access. You can now view your car's surroundings using the Tesla app while it's parked to make sure your surroundings are safe before you get back into your car. Here is the release note. View your car's surroundings from the Tesla app when parked to confirm the safety of your environment before returning to your car. Live camera is end-to-end encrypted and cannot be accessed by Tesla. To enable or disable, tap Controls, Safety, then View Live Camera via mobile app from the touchscreen display. Note, this feature requires premium connectivity. Tesla has made improvements to Apple Music. When playing a playlist or album, Apple Music, like other music services, will now display upcoming songs in the Up Next section. Tesla appears to also have made various improvements to improve the playback and speed when streaming Apple Music. Users will enjoy a smoother and faster experience when streaming music. Zoom Meetings. You can use the interior cabin camera to make video calls with Zoom. If you have a Zoom meeting scheduled, tap the link to start or join the meeting automatically. Here is the release note. Make video calls with Zoom using the interior cabin camera. If you have a Zoom meeting in your calendar, tap the link to automatically start or join your meeting. Participant video and screen sharing are only visible while parked and will switch to audio only if you drive. To access Zoom, tap Application Launcher, then Zoom. Note, this feature requires premium connectivity. Trip Planner. With the Trip Planner update, you'll be able to stop at superchargers if you need to charge to get to your destination. Here is the release note. Trip Planner will add stops at superchargers if charging is needed to reach your destination. When viewing nearby superchargers, in addition to location, distance, speed, and number of available stalls, vehicles now display cost per kilowatt hour. Here is the release note. When viewing superchargers nearby, the vehicle will now display the cost per kilowatt hour in addition to the location, distance, speed, and number of stalls available at the supercharger. The cost per kilowatt hour displayed may be time-based and could change depending on when you arrive. To preview your cabin camera feed, go to Controls, Service, and tap on Preview Camera. News and rumors have been heating up about Tesla's upcoming hardware for computer. Now, thanks to our Green the Only, we have our first look at version 4.0 of Tesla's latest FSD hardware. The new hardware will include not only a faster computer and higher resolution cameras, but also high-definition radar, more cameras, and new camera locations. First, let's look at cameras. It has been rumored for some time that Tesla will be using upgraded camera sensors with increased resolution. We pointed this out in our recent Tesla Model X and Model Y reviews. On the Model Y, we were reviewing the future. Tesla's current cameras produce 1.2 megapixels, and while we don't know what the updated resolution will be, there are plenty of rumors suggesting they will have 5 megapixels. According to one of our sources, while the increased resolution will be useful in certain situations, it will not be crucial, because the higher resolution has some drawbacks, like increased noise and the need for additional processing power, which we will discuss very soon. However, we anticipate that it will be useful in certain situations, and Tesla may even be selective about when it uses the higher resolution. The new cameras will also improve image quality and benefit non-FSD features like Sentry Mode. Let's look at camera placement. Tesla's hardware 4 includes 12 camera connectors, one of which is labeled spare. All current Teslas have a total of 9 cameras. There are 3 forward-facing cameras beneath the windshield, 2 on the fenders, 2 on the B pillars, 1 in the back, and 1 for the cabin camera. Leaked information suggests that Tesla plans to reduce the number of front-facing cameras from 3 to 2. This is probably due to the camera's higher resolution, which eliminates the need for a third telephoto lens. This means that the hardware 4 can have up to 3 additional cameras, or 4 if you count the spare camera. According to Green, the 3 cameras appear to be for the front bumper of the vehicle, although it is not clear which direction they will be aimed. Let's look at processing power. It is rumored that hardware 4 is around 2 to 4 times faster than hardware 3. Some of that power will no doubt go to processing the new camera feeds and the extra pixels the new cameras will provide. However, the extra power is essential as hardware 3 hits its processing limit. Green provided chip specs for the new hardware, revealing that it contains 20 cores up from 12 and maxes out at 2.35 GHz. Green also touched on the fact that the number of trip cores have been increased from 2 to 3, with one maximum clock speed of 2.2 GHz. Next, let's look at Radar. Tesla's Hardware 4 package includes an HD radar to boost vision. Tesla began removing radar from its vehicles in 2021, starting with the Model Y and Model 3. They then removed radar in favor of a vision-only system in their Model S and Model X. However, with Hardware 4, Tesla reintroduced a high-definition radar named Phoenix. HD radar is a step up from traditional radar, allowing Tesla to create images with greater precision using only radar. The inclusion of HD radar isn't surprising, as Elon Musk has previously said that high-resolution radar vision would be superior to pure vision. Tesla is also doing everything possible to protect its sensors with hardware 4. Not only will some cameras have heaters to prevent weather problems, but Tesla will also add a heater for the radar. The radar heater prevents snow and ice from accumulating in the front of the vehicle and interfering with radar signals. Will Tesla accept retrofits for hardware 4? During Tesla's earnings call last month, Elon talked a bit about hardware 4, saying it wouldn't be cost-effective to retrofit. However, given this look at Tesla's latest FSD hardware, all of this confirms that Tesla has no plans to offer any sort of retrofit. Hardware 4 is also much more than just a faster computer. Power consumption is much higher on hardware 4 than on hardware 3. The form factor is also completely different and won't fit an older vehicle model without modifications. Which models will have hardware 4? Green believes Tesla is currently producing Model S and Model X vehicles with hardware 4. However, Tesla is holding them. You might be lucky to get one, as some buyers have reported getting their vehicles with new-looking cameras. The Model 3 and Y lines in China were paused for retooling, which could be related to hardware 4. As Tesla transits to its vision system, hardware 4 will be available on all vehicle models. The craze for the Tesla Cybertruck is gaining momentum. Elon Musk says it will change the way people travel, and he intends to make the futuristic truck his daily driver. Millions of buyers are on the waiting list to drive this amazing truck due to its distinctive design and outstanding performance. A shareholder who attended Tesla Investor Day, Matthew Donegan Ryan, had the opportunity to speak with senior Tesla executives and learn more about Cybertruck. Several investors shared information about Cybertruck, but Matthew Donegan Ryan posted numerous videos of his conversations with Tesla executives. Let's start with the new size and variant of the Cybertruck. Rumor has it that the pre-production beta version of Cybertruck, shown off at Investor Day, is how the truck would look if it were available for purchase right now. The Cybertruck is about 5% smaller than the 2019 prototype. Because of the size reduction, the Cybertruck can only hold 5 passengers rather than 6. It will weigh between 6,500 and 7,500 pounds. Other investors are reporting 7,000 pounds. Configurations will come standard with rear-wheel steering. The Cybertruck will be available in 2 configurations, a dual-motor base model and a high-end performance model. Initially, it was assumed that the top-of-the-line trim would be a quad motor, but discussions with Tesla staff seemed to indicate that Tesla would abandon development of a quad-motor powertrain in favor of a tri-motor powertrain for the Cybertruck. Rear-wheel steering is standard on all Cybertruck configurations. Every Cybertruck will come standard with advanced air suspension. Tesla staffs told the Daring Investor that Cybertruck can handle almost anything. I was told very directly that they have tested the air suspension and they're confident it can handle Baja-style racing. The Cybertruck will have 18-inch wheels and at least standard off-road and all-season tire options. The tire dimensions are 285/65R18, which is 35 inches by 11.25 inches by 18 inches. The company in charge of making the tires for the Cybertruck will be Goodyear. Donegan Ryan estimates each tire will cost $385. The Cybertruck will have the largest display ever made by Tesla, with a diagonal of 18.5 inches, but it will not have an instrument cluster and heads-up display. The new Model S and Model X have 17-inch center screens, while Model 3 and Model Y have 15-inch screens. The steering wheel will be round on the sides with flat top and bottom edges, similar to a combination of a typical round steering wheel and the yoke steering wheel on Model S and Model X. New team is developing accessories for Cybertruck. The 48-volt architecture used by the Cybertruck offers more power, lighter and less expensive wiring, and a smaller accessory battery. Tesla has assembled a team of Cybertruck accessories for the vehicle, and instead of working with aftermarket companies to develop add-ons, Tesla will do it themselves. Off-road, camping and running are the 3 subgroups of the accessories team. That's it for today, guys. You can now support us using the Super Thanks feature on the bottom of this video. We will be back again for more EV news. In the meantime, subscribe, goodbye.